Hello, I am Chris Menard. In today's video, we're going to take a look at doing a 3D reference, referencing multiple worksheets in Excel. Two ways to do this. I see people using method one, which I'll demonstrate, but that is not the best method. Let's dive in right now. So to do a 3D reference, the worksheets need to be set up the same. I'm going to click on the North worksheet. Notice in column A, we got a list of candy bars, but they are in the exact same order on every worksheet. The numbers are different. So here's North, click on South, click on East, click on West, or use Control Page Up or Control Page Down to move around. Here we go. I'm on the report worksheet. I'm in cell B5. I want to add those up. Method one, I see people do this all the time. You'll get the correct answer, but this is not the way to do this. Equals North, click cell B5 plus South, B5 plus East, B5 plus West, B5, look up in my formula bar. All your worksheets will always have an exclamation point. That means they're a worksheet followed by the cell reference. Press enter. I get the number 5,361. Click it. There's the formula again. It works. Don't do it this way. If I add a worksheet, I've got to go and manually update this formula. Plus, I only had four worksheets, but what if I've got 200? That is a lot of mouse clicking. That would be 400 mouse clicks and 199 plus symbols with 200 worksheets. Here is the correct way to do this. I know that I want to add these numbers. Equals sum, tab. What's the first worksheet? North. I clicked it with the mouse. What is the last worksheet? It is West. I'm going to hold down the shift key. Click West. Perfect. Let go of the shift key. Look in your formula bar. North colon West exclamation point. They're worksheets. And now what cell do you want to add up? I just click cell B5 or type it in. You're done. Press enter. You should get the exact same number you had before if you did method one with me, 5,361. This way is so much easier if I had the 200 worksheets. Also, the other advantage is if I add a worksheet between North and West, which is the first and the last worksheet, it'll automatically get picked up. The other way would not. Let's test it. I'm going to click on South. I'm going to hold down the Control key. I'm going to click and hold down South now. And when I move South to the right and let go of the mouse, let go of Control, it named it South 2. Double click and rename it Midwest. Just to test this, just leave the numbers the same. Go back to the report worksheet, that 5,361 or 60, whatever it was, is now 6606. Perfect. I am going to delete the Midwest worksheet real quick. I am back to having just the formula over on the report worksheet. Bonus tip for you here. Take a look at my borders before I do this autofill trick. Here's my autofill. If I just autofill to the right, and then double click to autofill down, the numbers are correct, but the borders are all messed up. So I'm going to do an undo twice. Autofill, pull to the right. When you let go, use your autofill options and you want to tell it to fill without formatting. Autofill again with a double click. Fill without formatting the second time. Click anywhere you want to, and your borders are still perfect because I don't want to waste my time fixing borders. That is a 3D reference for you. Thank you for your time.